Right, well, it's Friday, so it's time for another video. This week is doing an African pygmy hedgehog, which has got to be the cutest thing in the world. Unfortunately, they do poo for England, though, and that is the one thing I've got to make you fully aware of before you go out and get one. They are cute as a button, but honestly, when I say they poo for England, I can't describe how much poo it is. It's ridiculous. If you keep invertebrates or reptiles already, you're probably used to cleaning up a bit of poo now and again. These guys will poo, poo, poo. Running the wheel, keep pooing, keep running, keep pooing, keep running, keep pooing, and then you wake up in the morning, you look at it and you go, I clean that, you little git. Breeders normally retail hoglets, baby hedgehogs, at around 75 to 125 pounds. That's the going rate at the moment anyway. But they do take a lot of care and attention. I mean, you have to house them in quite a big house for a mammal anyway, much bigger than a hamster or a gerbil, you know. They do like to roam a lot. They need a wheel because they run forever. I mean, she's quite a big girl now. She was born the 4th of January last year, so she's a little over a year now. But she's already quite a decent sized hedgehog. You feed them on a variety of high protein cat biscuits, anything with low fat. Iams, Purina, a mixture of the two is good. Dried mealworms now and again, but not too many, because obviously they're just pretty much pure fat and salt. And she'll be a bit of a chubby belly on her. Bit of upkeep of these guys anyway. The only thing really that you have to keep an eye on, same with most mammals, is their claws. They just need trimming every now and again, because if they start curling back, they can actually dig into the pad. Oh, sorry, Biscuit. And that obviously gives them some discomfort, so you want to try and watch that. But she is a gorgeous little hedgehog. She's always been so friendly. She's only huffing a bit now because I'm either scaring her or she's a bit hacked off at me for waking her up, which I would be too. Someone woke me up at like 3 in the morning just so they could pick me up and put me in front of the camera. I got turned into a ball of quills. But as you can see, she is absolutely adorable. But remember, they do poo for England and they need a decent sized housing. Minimum of zoo zone 2, which is about 3 and a bit foot long by 1.5 to 2 feet wide, I believe. That's the minimum. Most people keep them in vivariums because they need to be kept warm. And you can do that with a ceramic heater on a thermostat, of course. Fleece bedding is always a good choice because it keeps them nice and warm and toasty and nice and soft on the feet. And you can pretty much just pick it up, knock the poo off it and lob it in the washing machine. So that works quite well too. You can give them a bath. They recommend to do it just once or twice a year. I tend to give her one once every sort of 4 months or so about 3 times a year. Just give her feet a little bit of a scrub, tickle her belly with the warm water in it. They're not the biggest fans of water. Some are different, some love it, but Biscuit doesn't really like it for me. So handle them, as I said, just make sure you always have them supported. They do like to move quite a bit. They've got quite a big bum on them. So you just got to sort of predict where they're going to move to and make sure you put your hands in the right spot at the right time. I've never had her fall or drop on me, and you know, I've been handling her since day one. The more you handle them as well, the more tame and more used they are to you. There's a good reason to keep a hedgehog anyway. First things first, they're cute. So cute. It's unreal. They're relatively cheap to look after, especially if you already keep reptiles, because as long as your room doesn't drop below 19 degrees at the very lowest, you want to aim for at least 20. General rule of thumb though, you know, when you're looking after hedgehogs, is feel the belly. If the belly feels warm, she's fine. If it's cool, up the temperature a bit. You know, looking after them in terms of upkeep, you know, food bills and that, isn't too much either. You know, high protein cat biscuits you buy a bag of, it might cost you £7 or £8, but that bag will last you a month and a half, maybe 2 months. You can give them scrambled egg without milk and butter, of course, you know, lactose free. The pet food as well, I should add as well, you can't use any fish flavoured food. There's a bit of a debate going about whether they can actually digest fish or not, but to play it safe, I've never used it and I don't think I will, just because when I was first got her, I was told no fish. That's the only drawback to a hedgehog. Out of absolutely everything, the only thing that is a drawback with a hedgehog is the amount of poo. You saw that picture of the enclosure just earlier. That one, the whole wheel will be covered in poo. So will the entire litter tray. If you litter train them straight away, that's where they'll do all the business. That's not too bad. If they don't have the litter tray and the wheel, you're looking at poo everywhere. I mean, when we first got her, we had a big wooden bridge kind of thing. She'd climb on top of that and poo on it. She'd poo underneath it. She'd climb on top of the plastic house, poo on that, poo down the sides. Somehow poo up on the clear sides of the plastic. I don't know how she got up there or how she got her butt up there, but she'll still get up there and she'll still poo. Also, once a year, they quill, which basically means, you know, they drop all their old quills and grow out some new ones. It makes them a bit stressy. So, you know, if your hedgehog isn't as lovely and happy as this one is, don't worry, you know, it'll pass. It's kind of like a, kind of like being on the period for a girl, I suppose, but it goes a little longer than a week. She or he, I should say, will drop all the old quills, get some new ones. You'll be picking them up everywhere. And make sure you get them all, because you drop a couple on your carpet, and one day you decide to walk through your living room barefoot, you'll know about it when you stand on one. Ooh, that hurts. It's like standing on a sewing needle, if anyone's ever done that. You know, it goes right up into your foot and you go, can't swear on YouTube, but if I could, you know exactly what word I choose. But I mean, the belly's nice and warm, so she's good. She's not too bad. She's looking at me like, what are you doing? You know I don't like you touching my belly, but I'm going to do it anyway just because she's so cute. Just for display purposes, I'll get her to ball up a little more. Oh, still want to ball up? Yes, she will now. You see all of her quills, top and bottom, sides, everything, they all roll in to protect her, and her feet all tuck in. It's like she hasn't got any feet. It's such an amazing defence mechanism. I mean, wild hedgehogs as well, they carry fleas and mites and all kinds of other around the world, so I wouldn't recommend going and just picking one of these up to try and see if you can get a ball up. They'll probably ball up anyway, because they're obviously being wild, they're not tame at all. Whereas she's quite relaxed. I mean, she's balled up at the moment, but if I put my hand in front of her, she knows it's safe to stand on, because she trusts me. Me and her got a great relationship. Out of all the pets, she's got a special place in my heart. Right, so watering anyway. These guys, being from Africa, you know, they like it nice and warm, but they do need access to water constantly. They should never, ever, ever have a dry water bowl. Make sure it's always filled with clean, fresh water. Tap water is fine. I know some people like to go the whole hog and go, oh, we'll give them mineral water, or we'll give them distilled water, or, you know, chlorine-free, that sort of thing. But they're fine on tap water. Just make sure you change it every night. Most nights as well, it's probably advisory to do a small spot clean, because there will be the odd one or two bits of poo, which she's managed to flick 30 yards across the room or something. That's exaggerating, obviously. She's managed to flick maybe a couple feet inside the enclosure, and it's not where the rest of her poo is, so you think, oh, pick that up, and then that lot, which is in the litter tray, I'll give that a clean tomorrow or something. Look at that big old bum. You can't really stroke the quills. All right, I'll show you. Stroke the quills. That's what you get. You hear the sort of, not the breathing increase, but they start going, sort of saying, no, I'm not going to let you. If you carry on, it's going to get worse. And then they do one big tss, and that's when all the quills go whoosh, and you go, ain't touching you. I don't want to finish this video, honestly. I don't want to put her back. I just want to sit here and cuddle with her all day, because she's so unbelievably amazing as a pet. She's got such a lot of character. Sometimes she looks at me, she'll be taking a poo, and she'll sort of look up and go, as if to say, yeah, you're cleaning this up. Yeah, little bagger. Anyway, thanks for watching my video, and me and Biscuit really appreciate it. I'm gonna pop her back in her home now and and leave her alone for the rest of the day, because waking her up in the middle of the day has got her, made her a bit cranky. But yeah, keep an eye out for the next video. There will be a competition coming up shortly as well. I'm in the middle of organising it right now. As usual, I will update the page and spam every group to make sure you're all fully aware of it. Don't you worry. Till then,
ciao.